So this is what I was supposed to discuss with you. I had planned this to be an interactive session, but I think the syllabus part we have more or less confirmed what we are going to do, right?
Sir, actually, yesterday evening also, and all the faculty actually discussed, and they felt that you were thinking of conducting the workshop for 2 weeks. All of us felt that probably 2 weeks would be a very long period if you are looking only at C programming. The reason is they felt that capturing faculty for 2 weeks to, especially who are going to travel from outside and come and stay, it may bring down the numbers, because people don't prefer to stop their work and come out for 2 weeks. That's very difficult.
In the month of December?
No, even in December, because it's vacation. See, 80% faculty prefer to take their vacation. That is also...
The Ministry of Human Resource Development says that it is obligatory for the teachers in engineering colleges to attend so many courses. And in fact, they are saying that there are not enough workshops of the ISTE kind that the teachers can attend. I am told that for teachers in engineering colleges, attending IIT workshop is a requirement towards carrying or accumulating certain points for their promotion and recognition. It may not apply to your institution.
Yeah, no, all that is there, sir, but still, like, I am also the head. I have seen the feeling is we have 80% say female faculty.
Right.
So all of them prefer that 1 week we should spend with our kids, and with all these, it's very difficult to force people also to go. So, okay. Sometimes a very long period becomes a drawback. People don't mind for a week or... but if we expect 15 days of commitment, many people back out for personal reasons.
Actually, the workshop, if you have read my theme paper, the commitment was for 4 weeks, not for 2 weeks. 2 weeks they are physically here. The subsequent 2 weeks they have to go back and do some work.
That part will be okay. Going back and doing will be okay.
But no, it will not be okay. It doesn't get done. Believe me, the moment I go out, you look at, the best example is the teachers who come to IIT system for doing their PhD under QIP program. If they don't finish in 3 years, they say, okay, I'll go back and finish in, say, 6 months. They take 2.5 years more. Because once you go back to your own respective place, whether it is home or your college, there are day-to-day requirements that you have to put in. And you cannot put aside a time. A group environment is the only conducive way of ensuring that everybody participates in that activity.
Yeah, that is...
So that is one of the reasons. Secondly, in 1 week, I will almost guarantee that out of 1,000 teachers, at least 200 teachers will go back without understanding programming themselves. I can almost guarantee that.
Yeah, no, definitely.
I know how much I had to struggle to learn C++ myself. Having been almost a top-rated programmer in the country. I would submit it is not easy. I would submit that the hard problems that we wish to give, the teachers must solve themselves, must apply their mind and do it. And unless they do it, their teaching will not be effective. This is my conviction.
Yeah, that's
now,
true,
if you
sir.
Agree with this conviction, there is no shortcut. What you are looking at it is from the personal life point of view.
Yeah.
Well, once you decide to become a teacher, there is no personal life. We are on duty 24 hours. So I can appreciate this. What I am willing to consider is that originally I had planned that 2 weeks meant actually Sunday to Sunday. So it's 14 days and 14 nights of rigorous work is what I had planned. I think I can relax it now to say that 2 weeks, but they can occasionally sleep.
No, sleeping is not a problem. They would even mind working 10 days.
Believe me, unless they dirty their hands and unless they write complex programs of the kind that we ask. This lady just asked me a program, a simple code which somebody has given. Firstly, I sincerely object to somebody setting x minus equal to minus minus x minus x minus minus. What exactly are being achieved is not very clear. It's a very tricky code. And by the way, I also thought the answer will be 7, but the answer turns out to be 6. And I could figure out why. You are actually changing a part of the variable during the evaluation of the expression. Now, what we have to find out is the right-hand side being the same location, it probably is reflecting that effect. I'm sorry for digressing. She had given a neat problem. Now, I want our teachers to face 20, 50 such problems in an environment where they are not likely to be criticized by their students. Believe me, if I am teaching, I put myself into a small place and I am a teacher there. I will be terribly worried about students making comments on my programs.
Yeah. Actually, in Bangalore, we may not encounter because locally we'll capture a lot. But the people coming from these small cities, they had that fear.
I will tell you, even in a small place, if only 10 teachers come, but they work for 15 days, rather than 100 teachers coming working for 7 days, so 10 teachers are likely to be more effective when they go back.
Okay. Yeah,
the idea is to increase their effectiveness. You see, when you take 1,000 people, statistics will catch up with you. Hmm. Independent of what you do, some people will not benefit. I have a thumb rule, I don't know, it might apply to all of your places, but let me share that with you. Did I share this earlier with you? 20, 60, 20? No. In any organization, it applies to teachers. So you take a conglomeration of 100, we have 400 teachers, but 20% of the teachers are always self-driven. They will work, they will slog, they will learn on their own, whatever. And they don't need any incentive. You reduce their salary, you don't pay their salary, you pay them double the salary, whatever they'll work. 20% of the teachers won't work any which way. You double their salary, whatever. They will come 9 to 5 because somebody head is asking them to sign. They will physically be present, whatever. They will go to the class, they will teach. They will not change. In fact, if anything, they will try to ridicule the other 20%. Yeah, pagal hai. The 60% people are the cracks. Okay. All 60% people want to be recognized for their good work, also want to escape away with little work if possible. There are simultaneous strains which exist. Now, for the organization, it is important as to how you can drive these 60% towards those 20%. Whichever institute succeeds in doing that, the institute does well. Now, given that rule, if I have 1,000 people, okay, we are talking about 200 people of the first variety and 200 people of the last variety. And my ambition will be to even make those 200 people at the bottom feel that they are gaining something. So any reduction in time, permit me to say that with my experience, will be inadequate. Will be inadequate primarily from the practical point of view. You see, it is not completion of the syllabus that we are interested in. It is we want them to understand teaching methodology. We want them to experiment with different ideas of giving teaching the same thing. So that is why the syllabus that I am planning is, or the course conduct, is broken into two parts. The first part, they will be working as if they are students of programming course. But they will be given an elevated pitch because they will be expected to know programming. But believe me, the problems that we give them, many of them will not be able to solve quickly. That's the purpose. The purpose is not to fail them in evaluation or something, but to tell them that life consists of extremely complex problems and that programming will take some time and there's nothing wrong if I make mistakes. But they should be able to solve problems, that then only they will be able to face their students more confident.
Yeah, that's correct.
So there is no shortcut to this. Secondly, the technology that we are adopting, the interaction will not be as we are having here.
Yeah.
You saw yesterday the fiasco. Suppose out of a 7-day program, one day is lost like that. Out of 15 days, even after 15 days, I can't afford loss of one. So we have to guard against that. I am seriously thinking, after seeing what happened yesterday, is to prepare all the delivered lectures ahead of time and send you the DVDs, knowing that this lecture, this schedule will be this time. So in the worst case, aap DVD dal ke chalu kar do. Oh, master udhar bol raha hai Bombay mein, but this is what he is saying. And we can synchronize with telephone. Telephone works. I mean, these are the worst case thing. The point I am trying to make is that 2 weeks will be required. I will also tell you another point. You mentioned about the teachers, particularly the lady teachers who may be unwilling or whatever. Look at it from their own career perspective. A 1 week IST course gets them less weightage than a 2 week IST course. Am I right in that? So, towards their own career advancement, there will be some. Why do you think I am spending enormous amount of time in convincing IST to have an MOU? Okay. They were not at all very keen because they want us to conduct conventional programs, 25 teachers each. They said 25 teachers, we want to conduct 1,000 programs in the country. I said 1,000 teachers, 25 programs we will conduct. Now this notion they don't have. Okay, so we want, this is also another thing, the first pilot of this type. And I would not like to err on the negative side by which the pilot does not show visible results, because then the government will not permit the subsequent. My humble suggestion would be, let us do this for 2 or 3 courses and see exactly what the effectiveness is. And if we all agree that this is okay, we should continue it for other courses. So this is the suggestion. So 2 weeks appear harsh, but
we understand, it's very clear for us, but it's difficult to convince the people from the local places, because the moment they hear computer programming or C language, they feel that it's very light, and most of them feel that they're masters, even though that is not the fact. So it's very difficult to convince them through brochures or websites. And we need to clearly state the objective and how it is going to be implemented and what is the real target.
What do we call how to enthuse participants, right? How do we, basically marketing.
Yes, marketing.
And that is the problem. Even when we are doing good things, we are not able to tell people how good it is. But the marketing experts, without doing anything, they'll convince you how great things are being done. This is a challenge. Anybody here is an expert marketing person? Our Symbiosis Institute should be able to help. You teach marketing, right? Anyway, but I understand this.
They feel that what is there to learn for 2 weeks if it is C programming. So we have to really good in conveying this, and we have to do a proper marketing, as you
said. So it is, we will not call it C programming per se. The name of the whole program will remain effective teaching learning of computer programming. In fact, the IST and even others, MHRD and AICT, they call these programs QIP program, quality improvement program. For the last 35 years, I have objected to this one. I am a teacher. What you are telling me is your quality is so poor that it needs to be improved. I mean, okay, I may not be as great as somebody else, as a Nobel laureate or something, but I am a teacher in my own right. Why do you want to use derogatory words? So that is why I don't like the word improvement or whatever it is. It may, in truth, we might want to improve things, but I think the correct word to be used is what I have used. Enhancement of the effectiveness of the teaching and learning. The individual is an incidental thing in the process, because unless the individual improves, the enhancement will not happen in quality. So do you think even this title, enhancing the effectiveness of teaching learning of computer programming, may still dissuade people once they see the details? Because you are the people who have your feet on the ground, so you will know how the reception should be. Because you see, this is going to happen to all the courses that we plan to run here. We are saying, in our proposal to MHRD, that the core courses in engineering and science are not understood by students. And therefore, the increasing effectiveness of that learning teaching is most important. Once the core courses are done well, the other electives and other things, people may be able to master relatively easy. Now, if you say teachers will say what is there in C programming, if there is nothing, why 25% students are failing? Okay. When I teach a course, if 25% students of my class are failing, then can I legitimately say there is nothing in C programming? So that, but of course, these questions and counter questions we ask once they are here. The chicken and egg is they won't be here to listen to all these arguments. Now, how do you put forward some arguments in a simplistic form? So the conventional brochure will not do. That is first conclusion. In fact, we shall discuss some of these things in tomorrow's session when we have a special session on this. Tomorrow also we are talking about this, right? On the actual logistics arrangement for the, because there are so many other issues that we need to discuss. Last time when we had discussed, for example, what would be the cost of conducting such thing. So that time hurriedly people had gone and done some calculation, and now MHRD, which has done elaborate calculation, which says no, we will stick to the IST norms. Now IST norms are very clearly inadequate. Yesterday I was talking to some colleagues here, and they said they have 6 to 8 hours of load shedding. Now they can run the workshop, but they will have to run a diesel generator for 8 hours. And the diesel generator consumes so much diesel per hour. If I have to run it for 8 hours and if I have to run it for 2 weeks, then this is the extra cost which my institute may not be able to bear. Now, actually after that I had a long discussion, and also incidentally I talked to not Ministry of HRD person, but a Ministry of IT, one senior director. There's nothing to do with this, but he also approves funding and things like that. And when I was asking him, I have this peculiar problem. He says, Phatak sahab, that you can sanction through consumable budget. So it's a very funny situation that for teachers to spend money, I have to do it as per some IST 1932 norms, 2 rupees 50 paisa for breakfast, whatever. But for diesel, I can spend any amount of money. Now, this looks stupid to me. I'm still arguing with them, but we'll discuss these issues tomorrow. Anyway, conclusion is that the conventional brochure alone will not be adequate. We'll have to do something else. If you have any suggestions, you're most welcome to mention them. But first, let us consider this part. Are we frozen on this? We take the syllabus, which is essentially C programming. I would like to buttress it by the following. I would like to say, introduction to problem solving and computer programming as a little bit of introduction in first 2 hours. And I would like to conclude by saying the sequence of this particular course, such as object-oriented programming, which may come later. Now that may be useful to certain institutions which are actually teaching both. Okay. But it is okay if we use the style of teaching this course to teachers, which is Professor Ranade's style. That we will cover these topics which are actually required to be covered by them. But every lecture will have a problem theme which will be solved, using which, except for some few minor things. That is the style we will keep. My idea is to have half the amount of lectures and half the amount of practical. So we normally for such workshops, it's like an easy kind of thing, 3 hours and 3 hours. We can't afford that. The normal institute timetable in a college is 4 hours and 4 hours, right? Or 4 hours and 3 hours. Four break and 3 hours. Now 3 hours is usually lab. But for teachers, can we afford to have 3 hours of lab? We can do that if the first 4 hours are broken into two parts. So there are two labs actually. So first 2 hours, this is followed by one lab. Next 2 hours is followed by one lab, but both the labs will run concurrently for 1.5 hour, 1.5 hour in the afternoon. Or will it be better to break up lecture hours followed by lab, again lecture hours followed by lab? The pace will be extremely fast because I propose to cover this entire course, as we may call it, the syllabus, with the teachers participating, actually writing programs, making submissions exactly as students do. Okay. We would like to finish this off in the first 10 days. So let's put it this way. First week, we would like to cover majority of the syllabus in the labs, because I would like the teachers to do projects. We would like to encourage teachers to go back and give group projects to students as a part of this course, as a part of internal evaluation. See, one of the ideas is not only to encourage, to enable teachers to teach their current mechanism effectively. The other idea is also to let them think of alternative ways of teaching. Someday many of these colleges will become autonomous colleges or part of autonomous university. Someday the university itself may start thinking differently. Now, where are we preparing people for change? That is the question. And that is where I wanted to roughly divide this entire portion as 2/3, 1/3. So for 2/3 portion, we actually cover the course as rigorously as we would expect them to cover for students. And for the 1/3 portion, on one hand, they are doing a course project kind of thing with the group. And on the other hand, we are discussing issues related to teaching pedagogy, setting up of questions, finding out answers, and methodology of collaborative contribution to the whole effort. So the assignment that they will have to do after going back, the coordinators will have to actually look at those assignments when they submit from their own homes later. So my suggestion is, let's stick to 2 weeks and let's decide what should be the portion. If you agree that this should roughly be the portion, that is 10 days and 5 days. But we will not put all the working days as heavy as Sunday to something. We can put it like Monday to Saturday. And even if you want, we can keep Saturday half day or whatever. In majority of the places, I do not expect people to travel and stay at your institution. I would expect them to come in the morning and go back in the evening.
Well, if it is possible, we can leave off both Saturdays and Sundays and conduct it from Monday to Friday. In that case, is it possible for the entire course to get end by 10 working days, or should we go for again 3 weeks then? So that also comes.
No. We'll do it 10 days only.
10 days.
That is 2 weeks.
Ah, okay, right.
The total duration is 2 weeks, but their physical presence is required for 10 days.
10 days.
However, will it be okay if we give them some home assignment?
That is okay.
On the weekend, they can be at home, but at least 2-3 hours they will have to work and do some home assignment.
Sure.
And which they will have to submit Monday morning.
Sure, sir.
The only thing is, what happens to the home assignment for week two? Because that weekend they will be dispersed.
They can send it through mail. They can send it through mail, or they can...
In fact, as a matter of fact, we are going to set up an extremely strong logical network amongst all these people. They will be submitting not only to the coordinating institution, that will automatically also get updated into a large server which I am going to maintain here. And we'll have some automatic monitoring procedure as to who has not submitted, who has not submitted, etc. A simplest trick I have found out, same thing as students do when there is an evaluation. If there are marks, people will submit. So here we'll say that certificates will be sent to you by post after your assignments are received. That is a simple way. Although it is not very good to say that about teachers.
We should not say in the beginning, maybe after.
After giving the assignment. Anyway, but that's a minor point. So basically what you are suggesting is, I should plan all the contents, lab and everything, including the effectiveness and teaching mechanism, including other things, including the discussion on the collaborative content generation, etc., in 10 working days.
Because that will give us a little bit more time. For the first week, Monday to Friday, second week Monday to Saturday, because after that anyway they are going to disperse. So we'll have one more day for our planning.
See, the problem is those people who locally travel or come from nearby places, Monday to Friday is an extremely good thing. But suppose somebody has traveled and come to stay with you, then that Saturday, Sunday, he or she would have been delighted to have colleagues there doing work simultaneously. Now you're all running away, leaving me alone here. That's also the worry.
No, actually in the second week we can give short assignments every day. See, every day you can give a short assignment to be done from home. If it's not very long, half an hour, 1 hour, one can think after going home. It's not a big issue. When you are sitting in a training program.
How many people do you expect to be wanting to be away on the weekend? A very large percentage of people? Because you see, if you consider the time, 15 to 30th December, whatever planning, there is a Christmas vacation in between. That is 25th. Are you suggesting that people will refuse to work on 25th?
Yes.
No, logistics also in the college is sometimes a problem, because suppose we have it may not be if they are coming on their own and going back on their own, but... In Amrita we'll not have, but I don't know about the local.
There could be a problem. 25th is Friday. Okay, so in that case, my suggestion is, first week, why can't we have it Monday to Saturday? And second week, we close on Thursday.
Yeah, that is better, sir. Close it before Christmas, that week.
We can still call it, I am worried about IST asking me questions, how can you give 2 week certificate?
Okay.
Ultimately, if you do all this, teachers come, they will learn something. But at the end, if they don't get that 2 week certificate, They are going to shout at you as coordinators. Don't forget that what we are planning in that MOU we are writing is that the IST certificate will be given jointly by IIT and the coordinating institution. So each one of you or whosoever is your colleague who will coordinate this course will have to sign as coordinator on that certificate along with me or whosoever is coordinator from here. And that's a burden on your head if they don't get that certificate.
Can we start around 10th and finish it before, say, 25th?
No, 10th is not possible. Can we start on the Sunday?
We can, actually.
No, it will not work. Okay. Then why not we do it Monday through Thursday with a possible break on Sunday in between? But totally 10 working days as far as the workshop is concerned. So this is 11 days, and then
it becomes 10 days.
We can take 10 working days, IST is happy, and we should be able to confirm. In fact, this is better, because after 25th, again calling them for Monday or something, whatever, people will get into a New Year celebration mood and whatever. Psychologically, that will not be conducive.
Now, for outstation candidates, calling them and making them sit idle is not worth it.
I agree. And my objection that some individuals who will stay back on Sunday, they will not feel bad if they stay back alone only for one day.
One day, yeah. Yes. One day is okay.
So, by unanimous agreement, do we freeze these dates?
Yes, sir.
Kalpana,
yes.
Please note. But as far as our brochures and all concerned, we'll call it 2 weeks course. Because that wording is important for our friend Hariharan.
Sir, how is the publicity be done?
It will yes.
be from the IIT or from our universities?
Make suggestions. We are very bad at publicity.
We don't mind doing it. I don't know about other colleges.
Why not we do all of us together?
But
we will give the brochures. In those brochures, we will list all the names of the centers which are participating. And their email IDs or whatever. We'll give our brochure. We'll open up the registration site here. We can even say preliminary registrations immediately. Now, we will mail you sufficient copies of these brochures. These brochures will take at least 15 days to get ready. But that's okay. By middle of October, if you get the brochures, would you be able to additionally send them? Our problem is I had addresses of about 2,000 colleges at one time. And when we actually sent physical letters to the addresses which we had, okay, about 30% did not reach them. So we don't have sufficient addresses. Will you have contact details of the colleges around you? Okay, so if we can take this upon ourselves, Kalpana, so on the action agenda item, we'll say that all colleagues after going back, because we'll take 15 days to get the brochures ready anyway. Over the next 15 days, as many college addresses with a particular contact person's name, email ID, if they can get. Then we can ensure the following. Apart from you, we will also send all the brochures to them. I will write a letter to the principal or the director. And meanwhile, you can also follow it up by talking to the corresponding team.
It's good if it is directly going to the colleges.
No, it will go directly to the colleges, but additionally, we'll also send you additional forms. See, what happens when I send something directly to the college, it will be addressed to the director. Okay. The director will quietly keep it on his table. Or will he say, okay, mark it to head such and such department. And the movement of that paper to percolating down to the individual who is actually likely to be interested, I don't know how long it takes, depends. Some places it will happen quickly, some places it will not. So my suggestion is twofold. Yes, we do it, we send it to all the people, and we will inform you to whom all we have sent. So you know exactly which colleges it has gone. If there is any correction in address you want to suggest, you can do that. But if you, to begin with, give us some addresses, that would be nice. So let us put some target date. Say, brochures to be ready by, whatever, say about 17th October. Ready by 17th October. So it is less than 17th, not equal to. Okay. So the week after that, the posting will happen. About 5 to 6 days, you can say, all people will have these brochures. Now, around the same time, if you can also start pursuing this, and we will make the preliminary registration. Karthikeyan is here. Swati is here. So what we want is a preliminary registration site for the larger workshop, where they should mention the center at which they wish to attend. And ordinarily, the list is visible in terms of only the total number of people. But if the list could be visible also as sorted on centers. So normally, list visible as people have registered, but some click I do, and the same list is retransformed into sorted by centers. The point is, Coimbatore will know how many people are registered today, Surat will know how many people are registered yesterday, and they can monitor the progress of registration for each of the centers. So you can sort of take care of these things. Now, I also want to know what is the maximum number of teachers that you can accommodate in your centers. This is the other way around. So assume that there is a huge number of people who want to attend. Then what do we do? There is only one stipulation from IST that if the number is more than 30 or 35, then there should be two coordinators appointed. So we will treat this as two courses of 30 each. Means the same college is arranging that, organizing that. The physical arrangement is same. The lecture can be at single place. But there should be two coordinators. And technically, if there are two labs, not necessarily two physically separate labs, but two different set of people looking after them. Because the costing that we have done is assuming around 30 to 35 people per batch. That's the batch size for the total budget that we have. Okay.
So one suggestion I have here, because you are looking at that 60% faculty who will look for the credit, the organizing college, only the coordinator will not do much task. See, we will have to, suppose we have to help in the labs, we will have a team of 4 or 5 of our own faculty whom we will give all the assignments and they will actually help the 60.
Correct.
So some certificate, if it can be issued for those people. Because then they get a recognition of having participated in the activity.
What happens when you organize an IST course in your organization?
We have never organized till now. So.
No, participant certificates for teachers who participate.
So organizers.
Organizer certificate. Hmm. Exactly. Please feel free to give organizer certificate.
From our level or from something from your...
I can do that. That's not.
That will be good because that motivates them to contribute.
My own idea was that this certification should be done jointly. IIT Bombay and the institute organization.
Yeah, yeah.
So, for example, Nanded arranges this, or Amravati arranges this, or Bangalore, or Coimbatore, or Surat, or whatever. Whosoever is the coordinator from Surat, and whosoever is the coordinator from here, those two names should be there. And what we will do is, we will print two types of certificates.
Yeah.
One is the participating teacher for 2 weeks,
yeah,
and other is for organizational support.
Yeah.
Which would be given to local people.
Yeah.
All the names that you send,
That's
we will
better.
Just enter them. I will do something better which is not considered correct here. I will sign some blank certificates and send them. But I will count, say 10 or 5 or 8 or whatever. Now whenever you put the names there, you have to inform me that these have been used and the others are returned back. The certificates that IST considers something, I don't know why, something great or important or whatever. So, because there is a logistics, issuing those certificates. But is that okay? That will help.
So sorry for delaying it. So instead of providing the certificate, the supporting people will look for remuneration. That is very important concern over there. IST has the position. What about us? That is the thing. So that separation also we want to intimate, sir.
Okay. Actually, I use the word staff very loosely. It includes everybody from director of your institute to attendant. So, yeah. Now, do you have any figures which I can use to do some bin counting? So, what should be, for example, you said 10 days. So, 10 days of lectures plus lab. Now, typically, what is the kind of remuneration that you would recommend for, let's say, technical staff which supports, for the faculty members who participate in setting up the lab and conducting it, and for the coordinator? If I have some quick figures, we can do some quick addition. Because this has been the dilemma. I don't have any figures. IST does not distinguish like, they have given a list. Kalpana, they have given a list, right? The list of remuneration, etc., etc. I read somewhere, 12 rupees, 4 anas or something for doing this. It looks very stupid to me. I don't know. I feel the IST has to change its ways significantly. But whatever it is, I mean, you must be conducting some QIP programs or something
in
like
AST,
that.
In IST, they will give for coordinator around 1,500.
Okay.
2 weeks course. 2 weeks. 2 weeks. But what is the thing is?
Coordinator 1,500.
Yeah, that is the thing.
What is the coordinator?
Yes.
Coordinator.
What is the thing is the lecture was also supported by remuneration. Those who are taking lectures, we will give some remuneration for it.
Okay, but lectures are going to be given from here.
Yes.
So whosoever gives lectures, we will give them honorarium.
And similarly, supporting people.
But labs.
Yeah, labs.
Your people will have to be supporting that.
Yes, teaching staff, they will give. Per session, 500 rupees. Just I will tell it. Session is 1.5 hours. 1.5 hours session.
Per session.
Yes, sir. 1.5 hours.
Okay.
For technical. 150.
This is the lab assistant.
I didn't figure out it, sir, but normally it will be above 150 per session.
Same, per session. Okay. So let's do some simple arithmetic.
Per session, sir.
Yeah, I have said per session only. I am saying session is 1.5 hours.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. So let's do some quick calculations. If we have to run, let's say, lab, let's assume a median of 30 people. So in one lab, 30 to 35 people, how many you will have? At least one teaching staff and two teaching staff and technical staff. Basically, the technical staff is one which ensures that the setup has been done, software has been installed, and if there is a problem, that problem is resolved. It's like our sysadmins, right? Yeah, but employment is okay. They should continue to get their regular salary, but this is something extra that they are doing. You know, you call them on Saturday, ordinarily they will be hesitant. You call them early morning, you have to ask them to wait or something like that. And frankly, I don't see why people should not make some extra money if they are just showing additional sincerity and commitment. So that is why I was asking, if you take 150 per session, which item you are talking about? Let me say 1, 2, and 3. No, that's okay. This per session. We're talking about per session. 600, they are saying less. Let me put it grossly as rupees 500 per day, because it appears to be a round figure. 600, there is no justification. Okay. Now, I will tell you, because the lectures will be conducted from here. We are talking about 3 lab hours. So 1.5 hour, 1 hour, 1.5 hour. So there will be 2 sessions per day. So, basically we are saying 2 sessions per day into 10 days. Here also we are saying 2 sessions per day into 10 days. And we are saying 10 days here. Now if we do some arithmetic, can someone help? I can't add without computers. This one is simple, 5,000. This one is 20 into 150. 10,000, sir. Sorry?
10,000.
2,000 into 2, okay. Clerical staff. Here I and Kalpana do all the clerical work. Okay. Let's first consolidate this and, sir, let's see what other thing is required.
Technical staff, I think you can make it 250, sir.
250 per session?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No, don't make it too high. Why? No. What is this?
No, ultimately, I will tell you what he is trying to do. He is trying to make the whole proposal so infeasible that all teachers will have holiday throughout December.
No, I will tell you why I am telling this. Maybe technical staff, it's okay. No, just 1 minute. Teaching staff, it will amount to say 10,000 or we'll have to keep so many faculty on different sessions. The reason is there will be big politics in whom the head assigns then.
See,
if you have too much of amount, my faculty will say she gave chance to her friend, she didn't.
What, 10,000 rupees you mean?
Yes, it happens in local. See, now it is like one session is 1,000 rupees, three hours one day.
Yes.
Suppose I appoint a team of two faculty only doing whom I, or a three, they may end up earning 3,000, 4,000 rupees out of it. Now the people will say who should be appointed. See, there are people who look for money. So.
No, but they should know C programming.
Yeah, that's
all. I don't want a heat engines expert just because of the money coming in.
Okay, that's okay. Anyway, we can put...
Right now, let's do this computation.
Yeah, leave it.
We may have to tune it up or down because the total figures have to match finally. But let's just do what you are suggesting is we should make this 250.
He has...
So, this 500 into 10 is 5,000. So, this is also 5,000 into 2. Is that so? I'm just talking per staff. Here it is for the whole day. Here it is for 3 hours. That's the difference. And here, per person, it will amount to 10,000. And the coordinator. So now, I'll just add these and multiply it by 2, I think. Let us make it 3,000 here. Okay. I mean, give or take 500,000 rupees, but you think these figures are reasonable. Now, if I have to spend 43,000 rupees in the effective conduct support, this people's cost, you also said you should like to have one attendant or one whatever, a clerk or something like that. Let me put it this way. An attendant may be required to open the facility and close the facility in time and things like that. A clerk may be required to maintain the records, but that is not an activity which is related to number of days or number of sessions. That's a gross activity. Let us put some figure for that activity here, which is a consolidated thing. Like we said, coordinator is a consolidated activity. It is not this day or that day. In fact, the coordinator is the one, believe me, who will end up slogging maximum. But that's life. Okay. Frankly, anybody who is a coordinator here is doing it for 3,000 rupees. There's something wrong with either the coordinator or with us.
Whatever we are getting from IST and all, minimum 6,000 rupees is there. Okay. And one more doubt I have, like technical staff. So obviously we are going to use a TA, teaching assistants, or those are MTech guys.
Correct.
So I have one doubt, what about those guys?
You can pay them. Of course, you can pay them.
Same amount.
Yeah, we pay them exactly the same.
And one more doubt is because they are working and they are going to help a lot.
Yes.
So I need some sort of certification for them also.
For whom?
For those TAs, teaching assistants, those who are going to work.
Yeah. So we will be paying them, no?
Not staff. Those are the MTech students.
No. You use either staff or you use MTech students.
I am going to use MTech students because I cannot call my professors. All are.
No. I am talking. You are talking. Actually, you are talking about technical staff
for lab.
We have a provision for two.
Okay, sir.
What I am saying is, this is roughly we are using it for purpose of calculation.
Okay.
The coordinator has full freedom to do exactly what the coordinator proposes to do.
Okay.
See, I personally would have no problem if the coordinator opens up the gate, runs the e-learning facility, conducts tutorials and takes this entire money. Absolutely no problem. I also have no problem if the coordinator and some teachers decide they will run the whole thing. I have no problem if you have competent technical staff who run the whole tutorial. I have no problem if one person does the work instead of five people. I believe in autonomy. If you are my coordinator, then you decide what. But I'll tell you the problem. You will have problems if nothing is specified. because you are head of the institution, your other colleagues, the politics that she mentioned, all of these will work on you. So please use me to solve your problems. And I am willing to write different letters to different institutions. I have no issue. I am very shameless. My objective is to get these 1,000 teachers transformed from whatever they are to that plus delta. That's all. Nothing extraordinary I expect. So we will have this flexibility. I am just trying to compute. Now, per participant, how much is the expenditure that you will have to incur for a 10-day workshop?